In this video, we're solving a quick parallel plate capacitor problem where we're given the specs on the capacitor and the potential difference across the plates, and then we're going to solve for the charge on the capacitor and the energy stored in the capacitor. So these are square plates and they have a side length of 10 centimeters. The plates are separated by a 2.5 millimeter thick layer of paraffin wax, and we're told the dielectric constant for paraffin is about 2.3. And we're hooked up to a battery that provides a potential difference of 12.0 volts. So in part A, we want to get the charge on the capacitor. And if I go back to the definition of capacitance, that's the charge per volt, so C is Q over V. So if we want to get the charge on the capacitor, that's CV. Well, we still have to find the capacitance, C, and that comes from the geometry of the capacitor and the dielectric constant of that layer between the plates. So to get the capacitance, that's kappa epsilon zero A over D, where kappa is the dielectric constant, epsilon zero, the permittivity of free space, and then A is the area of the plates, little d is the separation between them. Plugging everything in, we get 2.3, the permittivity of free space, that's 8.85 times 10 to the negative 12, and we can write those units as farads per meter. The area of the plates, we have to convert to SI units here, so 0.1 meters squared. And the distance between them, also we have to convert that to meters. And I'll write that as 0.0025 meters. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 8.142 times 10 to the negative 11 farads for the capacitance. Now we can go ahead and plug in to this little equation, Q equals C times V. And we get 8.142 times 10 to the negative 11 farads times 12.0 volts. Giving us a total charge of 9.77 times 10 to the negative 10 coulombs. Next, to get the energy stored in the capacitor, we can use the formula 1/2 CV squared, and we plug in our capacitance, 8.142 times 10 to the negative 11 farads, and then our potential difference was 12 volts, and we square that. And to three significant digits, we end up with 5.86 times 10 to the negative 9 joules, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.